Hey, you guys, Dr. Nicole here, answering the big question of what if pelvic PT hurts? Ah, yikes, you guys. This is something that I get a ton of questions all over social media on what happens if pelvic PT is really hurting. And there's a couple of things we're going to go over now, but in general, the short answer is that pelvic PT really shouldn't hurt. We shouldn't have to treat a pain condition with more pain. That just doesn't make sense. A lot of times part of the problem is that our nervous system and our brain has sort of tagged that area as a threatened area. And so if we are continuing to have a ton of pain in that area, even when we're going to pelvic PT and it's supposed to be helping, the brain doesn't really be, isn't able to sort of tell that that's not a threatening action. And so we really want to make sure that you have a really open communication with your pelvic health physical therapist to make sure that you are as the patient are actually speaking up and letting them know that this is actually painful and it's in the range of pain versus just a little bit uncomfortable. So again, pain should not be used to treat pain. So we want you to be able to speak up to your pelvic health care practitioner. In general, my sort of rule of thumb is that something can be uncomfortable during therapy, right? We actually are sometimes, especially during the internal component, working directly on the areas and the pain generating areas. And sometimes that can be a little bit uncomfortable. And sometimes it might be a place where you might have symptoms flare up. Sometimes we actually take that as like a, ooh, good, we're on the right track. We hit the right area that might be contributing to your symptoms. But if that consistently happens, and if that isn't translating to an overall significant decrease in your pain or your pelvic floor dysfunction symptoms, and we need to have a conversation, a real good one, with your pelvic health physical therapist. We want to make sure that you're not overly painful during your actual treatment session. So as I'm treating, and if somebody is having a significant amount of pain and discomfort, then we back off. There are a million different other ways to access that same area and sometimes even different places in the pelvic floor where we can work so that we don't have to go at that really painful spot. So make sure you have a great conversation with your pelvic physical therapist. Don't be afraid to speak up. And if overall you don't feel like you can have a good, honest communication with your pelvic PT, it might be time to get a second opinion. There are so many of us that do remote consultations, that do virtual visits, and there also might be another practitioner in your area, and where it wouldn't hurt to just get a different perspective on your treatment approach. You have permission to do that. This is your body, and you need to make sure that you are articulating correctly to the pelvic physical therapist that this is not okay with you and that we need to figure out a different way to get to the same goal. Believe me and trust me, as a pelvic health physical therapist, there are so many different ways to help you decrease your symptoms. And so we can always have, I always want my patients to have an open communication with me about what's uncomfortable, what do we need to change, what don't you feel good about, so that we can optimize your pelvic health care and optimize your pelvic PT session and make sure that it's the most comfortable for you that it can possibly be, even if you have a pelvic pain condition. So again, the short answer is pelvic PT really shouldn't hurt, and we should definitely be seeing a symptom decrease overall with your treatment plan. You have permission to change your provider if you need to. And just please have the courage and have the wherewithal to be able to speak up if you need to your healthcare practitioner. Hopefully that helps.